the people I interviewed last summer, really everyone remembered the palace as being just the most beautiful theater. And once again, Goldfields, there were live events at the Palace Theater. So they actually had all of the graduations, literacy graduations, they had beauty pageants, they had singers that would come in, and it really was a community meeting space for people. And actually, I just remembered, I forgot to mention, with the Goldfields, at one point, the church had burned down, and they had church services in the Goldfields. So these theaters weren't just places to show films, they were really community meeting spaces. So the other thing that people remembered about the palace, too, was that they, in the later eras, in the 1940s and 50s, they would have midnight shows, and many teenagers would go and watch horror films. Many people have asked, well, was it because of the miners' shift work? But people that I interviewed tended to say that they it was teenagers that tended to go to these midnight shows. So, the next theater, Cartier, 1938. This one was also known for its westerns. And this was probably the number one memory that many people have of the Cartier, was the westerns. So John Wayne, this is the movies were very popular at the Cartier, and I thought I'd show you a little clip from The Big Stampede, which is one of the movies that was shown there.
Even men talked about this, and this gentleman said,
the Broadway is that this was actually the first lawsuit in Canada between Famous Players Canadian Corporation and Odeon. So I think people might remember I talked a little bit about Nathan L. Nathanson. So he started Famous Players Canadian Corporation, and then he decided he wanted to leave and start a different country company called Odeon. And he wanted to take some of the theaters that he had collected, possibly, you know, maybe not so openly, like the Hanson, DL, and Timmins. He wanted to take them to Odeon, and guess who came with him? Hanson as well. So the first lawsuit between these two companies was over the Broadway Theater, and this was actually a great time for me because most people think that Odeon and Famous Players Canadian Corporation were actually kind of mutually beneficial to duopoly. But in fact, there was a fight over the theater in Timmins. And I went to the Ontario Archives and I found the lawsuit. It actually wasn't that interesting. And shortly thereafter, they settled and Famous Players won. It's actually more exciting to read the American Trade Press because they always have these great headlines. You know, one round for Famous Players. Interestingly enough, the Porcupine Advance didn't really cover the lawsuit very much, but they did have an article here that Famous Players took over the Broadway Theater in Timmins. So, now let's get back a little bit to the memories of what people remember about going to the Broadway. So, it was helping during the Second World War, so this interview subject, remember that they sold war bonds there, particularly. They also had a promotion called Photo Night, and you would get a prize with this. He was a kid, and he didn't really like the interruptions of the film, so he wasn't too keen on these promotions, but this is what happened in the when it first opened. So another thing that people remember about the Broadway is that it was definitely a kid-friendly theater, so people remember going to the Broadways on Saturday morning for specials where they would show serial films and they would also have parties. So there was, in the late 50s, they would have the Elmer the Safety Elephant Club, and they had live music, and it was a real fun event for kids. Earlier on, they had the Famous Players movie clubs for boys and girls, and again, they would listen to live music and watch films afterwards. And this is one of the memories about the Elmer, the safety elephant, and the entertainment that they had at these events. So it wasn't, again, it wasn't just watching films. They had live piano players and singers. And it was a real event for young kids. Okay, so I'm coming near the end. Get to some Q&A's. I didn't want to talk too long, so I actually cut out a bunch of slides, and we'll have, I think, a good Q&A session soon. But the last theater was the Victory Theater, and we're going to go back a little bit about the contracts that I was talking about before, because this was what the original Grenada Theater was going to be, that Famous Players was going to build, and Timmins Theaters acquired in the contract with Famous Players. So this is from the Ontario Archives. I found the original theatre plan and found on it that it says Grenada Theatre, and I was like, oh, okay, this is starting to make sense a little bit. So this is what the Victory looked like. It had 8,000 seats, and later it was turned into two screens. But when it was built, it was the most modern theatre in Timmins, and people remember seeing some of their, you know, sort of iconic films of their youth at this theater. So it was obviously opened after the war, and this is someone that remembers just how modern and special it was. So people were very excited when this theater opened because it had a very large screen and a big balcony. So in the early days, I noticed in the 40s, there were a lot of sort of romantic dramas that tended to play at the Victory. And this is one here called Enchantment. I thought I'd give you a little clip of that.
Thank you. inside and spend a little time. See what the mirrors have seen. Know what the clocks know. Hear what the walls have heard. Listen.
Seems I've always loved Rollo. I must have loved him from the first day I was taken into his home. He was so thoughtful and helpful.
Would you like to see a rabbit?
And that was Pella. I grew to love him as a big brother. Until one day... I hated so much to hurt Pella. But love can be so tender. And yet so cruel and selfish, as it was even for Grizel, who dared not listen to her heart.
You'll be going away in a few days. I don't want to be hurt again.
I don't want you to be hurt.
What are you saying?
I want to be sensible. In Rollo's arms, I'm not afraid. Only hoping and praying nothing will ever tear us apart.
See, that Locke and I love each other. We're going to be married.
You can be married, of course.
Flora loves you. I'm sure she wouldn't mind waiting 5 years.